In Panama, it left the entire stadium in tears from the stands to the commentary box. In Egypt, it left amputees bouncing on one leg. Oh, and more commentators crying. And in Iceland, it took the Viking clap to a whole new level. Complete with, of course, more crying commentators. It's fair to say that just qualifying for the World Cup has a pretty special effect on a lot of different nations. Now, as the final set of 2018 World Cup qualifiers are played, those scenes we saw during the last international break may just be beaten. Football mad Peru are on the verge of qualifying for a World Cup. And if they make it, forget everything you've seen before. After coming a miraculous fifth in the South American qualifying table, the Blanquirrojas only have a two-legged intercontinental playoff against Oceania toppers New Zealand standing in their way of Russia 2018. And whilst New Zealand's all-whites are 112 places below Peru on the FIFA rankings, Peru are taking no chances, with the National League having been suspended an entire 3 weeks ahead of the playoffs just to make sure that the national team can be training together for as long as possible before the all-important games.
Sí, el fútbol ahorita está parado, ya que la selección peruana cuenta con muchos jugadores importantes que juegan en el torneo local. Y ya que los clubes colaboran con la selección y quieren ver a su país en el Mundial, yo creo que dan las facilidades para poder entrenar 2 semanas, 3 semanas antes enfocados en lo que es Nueva Zelanda.
But this is hardly a surprise to anyone who's been following Peru over the qualifiers. As ahead of their penultimate qualifier against Argentina, the Federation suspended the league a whole week early just to make sure the team were training as early as possible. They also paid Brazilian club Flamengo to bring the Peruvian striker Guerrero into camp early. And just to be extra careful, the Peruvian FA brought their own water to Argentina to make sure the players weren't possibly poisoned. Over the top, you might say, well, when you see what the national team and making the World Cup means to these people, you may just change your mind. I mean, this is the nation where you'll see tens of thousands celebrated in squares across the country, or witness the 5,000 fans who welcome the national team at the airport in Argentina.
Me siento contento, con esperanza, con mucha fe, con muchas ganas de ver ver a mi país en el mundial.
Or see the president declaring a national holiday for their match versus Colombia. Or this incredible footage. We're seen subtly watching and even celebrating their team's win against Ecuador at a funeral. It's fair to say the national team qualifying for the World Cup means everything to Peru.
Lo que a mí me llena, sinceramente, jugar por la selección es un sentimiento diferente, ¿sabes? Porque no hay nada como cantar el himno nacional con todos tus compañeros abrazados antes de empezar un partido. Un estadio lleno con todos tus amigos, todos tus familiares que te están mirando. Y no sé, no sabría explicarte exactamente lo que es sentir ser peruano, ¿sabes? También a la vez.
Because this is South America, the continent where every single nation is talented enough on the pitch and passionate enough off the pitch to make it to the World Cup. So they don't call them qualifiers. Instead, they call them eliminators.
Yo estuve en una eliminatoria pasada. Y es complicado, ¿sabes? Porque el grupo de Sudamérica es súper, súper difícil.
Difícil, súper,
súper, súper difícil.
If you're not facing one of the game's historic powerhouse nations like Brazil or Argentina, you're facing one of the modern day stars like Alexis Sanchez or Falcao. And if it's not them, then it's some of the toughest away days where you travel to places like Ecuador or Bolivia, where you're as high as 9,000 feet in the air, hostile, always sold out, aggressive crowds, who yearn for qualification as much as any nation on earth. Every match is a physical, emotional, and mental battle of wills between 10 nations that are equally as passionate about the game, the national team, and the World Cup as each other. And Peru know this better than anyone, as not only have they not made the tournament since 1982, they haven't even come close in decades. Finally, they've snuck into the fifth place, and even just to do that, they've had to go on their best run in decades, undefeated in a 13-month, 8-game streak that has seen them get points at some of the hardest grounds in international football. So whilst you may think you've seen it all from the celebrations in Cairo, Reykjavik and Panama City, this week, if Peru end up victorious after 2 legs, check in with Lima, because you're going to be in for the party of a lifetime.
Solo escuchar lo que me dice. Se me escarapela el cuerpo, así te lo digo. No sabría decirte cuál sería la reacción del pueblo peruano, si Las calles van a estar repletas en Lima, no sé, yo creo que van a dar la semana libre a todos los peruanos, no sabría decirte exactamente, pero lo que hemos generado y lo que se va a generar después de estos dos partidos, si es que vamos, yo creo que va a ser una locura, la verdad.